Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to our closing concert for Brass Fest 2018. This is our 20th anniversary for this festival, and we've had some of the really outstanding groups in the country come through and be part of this great program. So we thank you for coming out tonight, and we hope that you enjoy the show. I have one great old friend in Quintasonic and four new friends. So it's a real pleasure to get to interact with them today. So if you'd please welcome Quintasonic.
Thank you so much for coming this evening and spending your Sunday evening with us here. We've had a great day here at the WIU Brass Fest, working with great collegiate and high school students. And I encourage all those who are visiting WIU today to come back next year for this annual event. My name is Jason Doval. I teach trumpet at the University of Kentucky. We are the Quintasonic Brass. The first piece we played was Escape by the American composer and trumpet player Kevin McKee. If you're not already familiar with that name, you should check him out on his website. He's written a lot of great music for brass quintets, trumpet ensembles, solo instruments. I know there's a couple of great solo trumpet pieces and also has pieces for other brass instruments. The next piece we're going to play is both the oldest and the newest piece on the program. The Baroque Trumpet Suite is based on material originally written in 1638, some of the very oldest music we have written for brass instruments. It was written by an Italian trumpet player, Fantini, who wrote one of the earliest method books for brass instruments. Has kind of a funny title, a really long title, but the abbreviated title is The Method for Learning to Play the Trumpet in a Warlike Way. And in the back of that method book are several solos. These were originally unaccompanied solos, and I took five of these solos, five of these ricercata, and wrote new melodic material to support the melodies. So this is the Baroque Trumpet Suite, written for the valveless natural trumpet. Thank you.
Hi, everybody. Thank you so much for sharing your evening with us. Dr. DeVelz, he's introduced himself. My name is Alex Lappins, and I teach tubing euphonium at the University of Tennessee. This is Vince DiMartino, who has done everything everywhere. This is Dr. Matt Hazel, who teaches at Mississippi State, and Alex Van Duren on trombone, who teaches with me in Knoxville at the University of Tennessee. And we are so happy to be here. We've been on the road for several days. This is our fourth recital in as many days, and it is just such a tremendous pleasure and privilege to get to go on the road and play great music with your friends. So thank you very much for this opportunity. We are going to finish up this first half of our concert with the big piece on the program. I think about food all the time, and I was thinking about introducing this piece tonight, and I heard the mention of, again, that Italian buffet, which again is just a concept that excites me. So I was thinking, you know, this is sort of like a multi-course meal. You know, we have Escape, which is this big flashy, maybe it's like spicy nachos appetizer. And then we have this beautiful Baroque suite, which is kind of like, you know, maybe the pasta course in an Italian restaurant. And then we get to the big, huge filet mignon, which is the Ewald. And then the entire second half is essentially one dessert after another. It's just a bunch of like pastries and ice cream and cake, and it's just, you're gonna love it. It's so much fun. But before we get to dessert, and before we get to sort of an intermission while we all digest the first part of the meal, before intermission, we're gonna play Ewald Quintet number 1. I'm sure a lot of people in this room, if you are brass players or fans of brass music, you're familiar with Ewald's music. Ewald was a Russian composer, lived about 100 years ago, and he wrote several pieces for quintet, for full choir, and they are absolutely central to brass players' repertoire. I would say that probably this next piece might be the most frequently performed full-length, big scope work for brass quintet is Ewald's first quintet. Ewald was writing at a time in Russia where the customary activity of musicians was to play different kinds of instruments in the summer and winter months as weather allowed. And Ewald himself was a tuba player and also played cello. And in summer, when the weather allowed, he would play his string instrument. In the winter, when it was colder, he would play his tuba to keep him warm and snuggly at night. And there was a lot of influence from the onslaught of string quartets in the 19th century. That's all you did in the 19th century was hang out and play string quartets. Everyone did it. It was the cool thing to do. And they had all this amazing music from Beethoven and Schubert and Schumann, and really sort of setting the standard for what chamber music could do and how it could sound. And the great thing about Ewald's music is that it is heavily influenced by that period of composition. And unlike a lot of modern brass quintet pieces which play very much off the contrasting textures of the cylindrical trumpets and trombone and the conical horn and the tuba, where you get a lot of diversity of palettes, like in the music of Arnold or Boza or Awaisen. This is music that relies heavily on blend, and it's one of the great joys to work on ensemble and matching, and it's such a sense of camaraderie and brotherhood or sisterhood in playing. Playing this music makes me feel better about the whole world. And so I hope that it does that for you. It's not too high a bar, right? So here it is, Victor Ewald's Quintet No. 1, followed by a nice brief intermission, and then we'll be back with all the desserts you can handle.
Thank you. Thank you. I always felt extremely challenged both musically and academically at Western. It was a fine graduate studies program and a lot of really great opportunities for performing.
During my time at Western and my lessons with Dr. Briney, he pushed me very hard. I'm somebody who likes to tackle a lot of material as quickly as possible. He did his best to teach me some patience in that, but we did cover a wide breadth of material, and I was lucky enough to be able to perform in lots of different ensembles on campus to apply those skills.
I'm just very convinced that I wouldn't be studying here at Northwestern today if it hadn't been for the great education that I received at Western Illinois University.
I have to say, Dr. Briney was absolutely, positively the best fit for me. Not only is he a fantastic trumpet player and a fantastic teacher, but he's so giving of his time, and he's so dedicated to his students.
As a jazz trumpet major, I took lessons with Dr. Cooper, but I also took lessons from Dr. Briney, and one of the consistencies I found in both of these gentlemen is that they didn't just give me the same type of studies that they gave everyone else. They take the time to find out what your goals are and where you plan to be at the end of your studies.
The thing that I really liked about Western was they have many different music degrees that they offer. My degree was in music performance, but they also offer degrees in education, music therapy, music business, and so on. And it's really great to interact with students in fields that are different from yours, so you really become a very well-rounded person and you understand and discuss music in its many different facets.
It was a great time where I got to study classical literature with Dr. Briney. I got to study jazz improvisation, jazz style with Dr. Cooper. I played lead in the big band. I played second trumpet in the brass quintet. And these experiences helped me so much when I got here because the University of Miami is very much into crossing, bridging gaps with all types of genres, all types of music, and I was prepared because of my experiences at WIU.
I do believe that my time at Western was very effective in preparing me for my current career as a music educator in the northwest suburbs of Chicago, as well as a freelance trumpet player around the Chicago area.
The time that I spent at Western Illinois University was magnificent. And I learned so much about the kind of human being I wanted to be and still try to be every day through those weekly lessons.
The teachers and faculty at Western are more than willing to go out of their way to help you be the best you can and push you as far as you want to go.
My time at Western Illinois was fantastic. I had so many resources at my disposal, great teachers, great performing venues, and just great opportunities to perform.
I think there's a lot of very, very high quality teachers and musicians coming out of Western Illinois University, and a lot of it has to do with the quality of the applied faculty, the standards that those faculty hold to their studio members, and the standards that the ensemble directors hold to their ensembles.
One of the exciting things that happened at my time at Western Illinois was the opportunity to perform. Dr. Cooper would set up tours for the Jazz Studio Orchestra in places like Chicago at the Jazz Showcase in St. Louis with artists like Chris Vidala and Bobby Shue. One year we got to perform in Brazil even, and that was the same year we performed 50 different one-hour sets throughout the year. And that's where I felt like I grew as a musician, was by performing in front of people and taking the opportunity to learn in both the big band setting as well as a small combo setting.
I chose Western for one reason, the faculty. And I was really struck with the personal impact and the personal relationship that they wanted to develop with students. I really got a genuine sense that they really cared about my progress and my future as a musician and a music educator.
There's something special about this place. There's something special about the studio with Dr. Briney and the amazing mentor faculty across the board that they have there, and the camaraderie amongst the peers and the students.
I really hope that you consider Western Illinois University to be your college of choice. I know it was one of the better decisions that I've made.
I give my highest recommendation to all students to come and have a lesson with Dr. Briney and get to know him just the way that all of his students have. And I promise that you won't regret it.
We are Western Illinois University, and we are amazing.
On Fridays, we wear purple.
We are home to professional athletes and actors,
lawmakers, CEOs, a civil rights leader,
and a three-star general, plus over 100,000 other impressive alumni.
Our programs are mighty. Our law enforcement program is the largest in the state of Illinois and is known internationally.
Supply chain management boasts a nearly 100% job placement rating.
And cornfields might surround us, but we have a fine arts program that can rival any large city.
It's okay to take courses in wine tasting, wedding planning,
scuba diving, grain drying, Renaissance art,
engineering computational methods, or advanced federal taxation.
Sometimes our classes even take us to Disney World.
The Apostle Islands, Greece, France, all around the world.
For fun, we spray paint a bulldog statue, race cardboard boats, and shave our heads and dance all night to raise money for charities.
Not only do we paint the paws before homecoming, but we show our love for our mighty mascot, Colonel Rock, with painted statues all over town.
Sometimes we play volleyball with a giant pink ball, and sometimes we play in the mud.
It's totally normal to look at our res hall windows and see a hot air balloon floating by.
Or experience all four seasons in one day.
Hey alumni, jump on that Amtrak from Chicago or St. Louis or anywhere in between.
And come back to get a horseshoe,
listen to the award-winning jazz studio orchestra,
or tailgate before a D1 game.
Not every school can say they started the four-year cost guarantee program
and have a second campus on the banks of the mighty Mississippi.
We are Western Illinois University.
And we are the Leathernecks.
Thank you. Thanks very much. That was an arrangement that I did out of necessity. My wife, when we got married at the Great American Brass Band Festival, believe it or not, with 400 of our closest friends wandering around the park. It was outdoors. And my wife made such wonderful arrangements for the whole wedding. We had, you know, food, all that. She says, all you have to do is get the music ready. I said, oh, how hard can that be, right? So I got all the most of the music together, and my brass quintet played. And she says, but there's only one tune I want, and it's Simple Gifts. So I said, oh, that shouldn't be hard. You know, I just started looking through the catalogs, you know. And then I realized that there was no brass quintet arrangement of Simple Gifts. And it was like a week or so away. I said, oh, my. So I stayed up all night, and I did that arrangement. And everybody seems to like it, so we continue to do it, and I'm happy to do it. The next piece is, of course, you know, in Kentucky, Shakertown is right near where we live, so it's beautiful. If you haven't been there, do go. It's beautiful. The next piece we're going to do is a tune that was really made famous by Mel Torme, the singer. He really sang it more often than anyone else, and it's called A Nightingale Sang in Berkeley Square.
Thank you. Thank you very much. As we mentioned, the last tune was arranged by Jack Gale, and actually everything that's coming up except for one thing for the rest of the program is arranged by Jack Gale. Jack Gale is a really wonderful arranger for brass in a variety of styles, both swing and sort of commercial classical styles, as you're going to hear with the next tune. If you're doing any sort of brass chamber music in your studies or aspiring to do any brass chamber music, you ought to make sure you find Jack Gale's stuff, because it's some of the best that's out there. And our group, I think, we all find it an important part of our identity as musicians to be able to play a variety of styles. We really enjoy playing commercial jazz music, and that's why our second half is sort of catered towards that, so we can bring out that part of our musical voice. So the next set we're going to do is three movements from the eight-movement suite that Jack Gale arranged of West Side Story, Bernstein's West Side Story, of course, a famous musical, Shakespearean musical. And with the three tunes that we're going to do are I Feel Pretty, Maria, and America, and I hope you enjoy these popular songs arranged by Jack Gale.
Thank you so much. It's been so wonderful to be here for the Brass Fest this year. The students that we heard playing today were just absolutely incredible. Really fine musicianship being ingrained here. And to the high school students who are here, we greatly invite you to check out the things going on here at Western Illinois University even further. A lot of amazing things happening here. So, and to our hosts, thank you so much for having us and for being just so gracious and hospitable to us. We really enjoy being here. We're not done yet, but I just wanted to put in my chance to say that to you. So, the next piece we're going to play is really quite special. And as a horn player, playing all of this jazz is pretty special for me because we don't get to do it so much. So the next piece is Misty, and it's going to feature Dr. Alex Van Duren on trombone. And one of the great things about being in a brass quintet and being a horn player is it teaches me so much about improvisation and adding jazzy elements beyond what's written on the page. And these guys are so great at that. They're just really, I learn every time I play with these guys. So we hope you enjoy Misty.
Thank you.
Well, we're going to play one more for you. I think I can last one more. But it feels like Father Time and his grandchildren up here. But it's wonderful to work with these guys. And thanks for having us, Bruce Briney, concert series. It was wonderful brass day today. You know, I these things never get old. I learn something every time I go somewhere. It's just a wonderful thing to be at every university. Support your university, support the music programs. We know nobody else is, but we do. You have friends that enjoy music, bring them to the concerts. Because concerts are, there's nothing like a live concert, you know. And if you have time this summer, the first weekend in June, come to the Great American Brass Band Festival in Danville, Kentucky, where you'll see about 30,000 of your best friends wandering around in our little town. And it's a lot of fun. We have a lot of great groups. So come on down. It's free. Doesn't cost anything. So thanks very much. We're going to do one more tune for you, and it's called Royal Garden Blues. Thank you.